In this part, we'll talk about the other types of racemose inflorescence. We have already discussed six types in which the main axis was very long. Now coming to the next type where the main axis is not that long, but the basic characteristic features, that is, it is going to continuously grow and it never terminates into flower, remains the same. So this one is corymb. It is known as corymb inflorescence. In corymb, the main axis is not that long. So if this is a shorter main axis, then the nodes are also very close. So the nodes are all very close to each other. And the flowers which arise, they are again in acropetal manner, but let us draw some flowers. This is the flower which is the lowermost. And as we move up, the flower size is going to get smaller and smaller. But if you observe it carefully, you find that as we are moving towards the upper side, the length of the pedicel is decreasing. That means this lower, older flower has longest pedicel. And this upper flower, the length of the pedicel is getting shorter. But because of this differential length of the pedicel, what has happened is all the flowers, they come to lie on the same plane. But the main axis remains shorter. So in case of corymb, the main axis is short and the flowers are in acropetal order, but the length of the floral stalk or pedicel varies. The lower flowers have longest pedicel and the upper flowers have shorter. All flowers come to lie on the same plane. The example of this is cauliflower. In case of cauliflower, if we cut cauliflower vertically, we find that there is a compact structure, which is the axis, and then we find there are these structures which come to lie like this. So all of them basically come at the same plane and these are tiny inflorescences. So this is corymb. A very similar is the next type, which is called the umbel. In umbel also the main axis is short. So here also we'll draw this short main axis. And it is much shorter as compared to this one. That is, in umbel, the main axis is even shorter. And all the flowers, they seem to arise from the same point. If it is very short, the nodes are going to be very close to each other. And all the flowers, they arise more or less from the same point. So, here, all the flowers, they are going to have the same length of their pedicel, because of which again they are on the same plane. So here, flowers have same length of the pedicel. In case of umbel, we have two categories. One is called simple umbel, which we have drawn, and the other one is going to be a compound umbel. So, example of simple umbel is onion. And in case of compound umbel, the example is coriander and carrots. So, these are compound umbel. What would be in compound umbel? The main axis is going to be like this. This is going to be one umbel. That means here a branch. And all the flowers are going to be like this. Again a branch, all the flowers like this. This is how it is going to be, the compound umbel. So that we will see in coriander and carrot. So in both these, that is corymb and umbel, the main axis is shorter. Now we come to the last two types of racemose inflorescence. That is 9th and 10th. In these two, the main axis is going to either become flat or globular. So first one is here, that is capitulum. In capitulum, the main axis is flat. So this is how the main axis is going to be. Instead of a long structure, it becomes a flat disc-like structure. We'll have to imagine it a little bit. If it was a long axis, the flowers would have developed from these areas or from these nodes. Now, if we compress this, if we press this long structure, then the nodes are going to be here. Basically, it is the same axis which has become flattened. So, the outer flowers are going to be bigger, and as we move in, the flower size is going to go on becoming smaller and smaller. Here, if it was a long axis, then here would have been the bigger flower, here would have been the smaller flower. When we press it, this part comes in the center. So here are smaller flowers. That means arrangement is still acropetal. In case of capitulum, the example is sunflower, sonchus. Another example is sonchus. Here we find this type of inflorescence. In sunflower, the outer flowers, they have this big yellow colored structure. These are known as the ray florets. And the central flowers, which are on this disc-like axis, they are known as disc florets. The details of these ray florets and disc florets we'll talk of when we come to the section of families. This belongs to family Asteraceae. So when we discuss Asteraceae family, we'll be talking about the structure of ray and disc florets. But this is where the main axis has become flat, disc-like. This is called capitulum and the example is sunflower. The last one, where the main axis is more or less globular. So main axis has become like this, bulb-like. And this type is known as capitate. All the flowers, they are arranged on this globe-like or spherical main axis. So we find that the flowers, when they get arranged, it appears in the form of a ball-like structure. And the example is mimosa, acacia. These are the common examples where we find the capitate type of inflorescence. So here we have seen 10 types of inflorescence under racemose. First 6 categories were the ones where the main axis was very long. 2 where main axis is shortened. And 2 where main axis becomes more or less flattened. So basic structures, basic properties remain the same. That is, the main axis never terminates in the flower. It always grows or it has unlimited growth. The floral arrangement is acropetal and the axis is monopodial. Monopodial means it is going to be only one structure which gives rise to the main axis. So these 10 are the types of racemose inflorescence. Now from the next part, we'll start with the next type, that is cymose inflorescence.